everyone, the fire behavior training is now over. I think I passed. On another note, lightning! Yesterday's forecast, 14 with a range, 19 down to 10. At the stake this morning, 21. We'll verify the two-day total after we see what tomorrow morning brings. The picker has another 19 for tomorrow with 12 2 days later on Monday. And that 12 could be sweet with max temps of only minus 2. After that, the freshies get scarce, but note the winds pick up Wednesday, and by Thursday morning, the two models show an average of 6. That's worth watching. The spinning cinnamon bun offshore is a maturing low that's losing its sweetness as it ages. Not really surprising. It's just a spinning mass of cold, unstable air with plenty of lightning flashes offshore. And when you zoom in, it's sending blobs of moisture north to Whistler. The pancakey texture is embedded convection, otherwise known as instability, practically known as thunderstorms, or at least potential for thunderstorms. The heaviest radar returns, precip, is in yellow, and that's also where the chance of lightning is greatest on the radar here. If you're wondering why you never see precip over Whistler on the radar, it's because Whistler is just outside the reach of the radars. However, another radar will be deployed to Mount Washington on Vancouver Island within 2 years or so. Soon we'll all be watching and timing the incoming precipitation. There's the mass of cold air centered on the low, which will hang around through tomorrow morning. Sunday, another storm moves in yellow here, which represents 25 millimeters in the previous 12 hours. Monday, we're still in the cold air, but that lump in the dashed red line is warm air with an approaching ridge. Tuesday, the lump moves over Whistler, but look at the kink developing upstream of the lump. These are technical terms, I know. That's a wave in the upper atmosphere. Physically, it's just another mass of cold air from the north, beelining it to the equator, desperately trying to beat back the northward march of spring. In any case, take note of Wednesday when moist northwest flow from the Gulf sets up. That's the SRS flow in the S2S. Skiers, riders, and sledders flow because it's cold and moist. The trick will be how moist, and will the moisture get a boost from the low that moves down the coast? It's very early, but I have my eye on this storm and its potential for perfect PFP. Cheers, and this powder tease is out.